فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل، وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد، إن شاء الله تعالى today's benefit is going to be from سورة القصص، and we're going to take the benefit from this particular surah, this particular story. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said,
وَلَمَّا تَوَجَّهَ تِلْقَاءَ مَدْيَنَ قَالَ عَسَى رَبِّي أَنْ يَهْدِيَنِي سَوَاءَ السَّبِيلِ ولما ورد ماء مدين وجد عليه أمة من الناس يسقون ووجد من دونهم امرأتين تذودان قال ما خطبكما قالتا لا نسقي حتى يسدر الرعاء وأبونا شيخ كبير فسقى لهما ثم تولى إلى الظل فقال رب إني لما أنزلت إلي رب إني لما أنزلت إلي من خير فقير فجاءته إحداهما تمشي على استحياء قالت إن أبي يدعوك ليجزيك أجر ما سقيت لنا فلما جاءه وقص عليه القصص قال لا تخف نجوت من القوم الظالمين قالت إحداهما يا أبت استأجر إن خير من استأجرت القوي الأمين قال إني أريد أن أنكحك إحدى بنتي هاتين على أن تأجرني ثماني حجج قال إني أريد أن أنكحك إحدى بنتي هاتين على أن تأجرني ثماني حجج فإن أتممت عشرا فمن عندك وما أريد أن أشق عليك ستجدني إن شاء الله من الصالحين قال ذلك بيني وبينك أيما الأجلين قضيت فلا عدوان علي والله على ما نقول وكيل.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said in ayah 26, قالت إحداهما يا أبت استأجر إن خير من استأجرت القوي الأمين. The story is that Nabiullah Musa alayhi salam, he went to a place called Madian. And when Nabiullah Musa went to Madian, he saw two women who were standing a bit far from a group of men who were at the well. And the men were taking, they put their buckets in, they were taking the water and they were leaving. But these two women, or two ladies, they were standing a bit further and far from the men, standing there waiting. Then what happened was, Nabiullah Musa alayhi salam, he went to them. He went to both of them and he asked them, قَالَ مَا خَطْبُكُمَا, what is your story? And then they told him that, قَالَتَا لَا نَسْقِي حَتَّى يُسْدِرَ الرِّعَاءَ وَأَبُونَا شَيْخٌ كَبِيرٌ. They said that we do not go forward and we do not basically push ourselves and rub ourselves with the men. We don't go in until they leave and they depart. When everybody's gone and he's done what he wanted, we then go and we take our water. And they also reminded him, they said, وَأَبُونَا شَيْخٌ كَبِيرٌ And our father is an old man. So just in case Musa doesn't ask them, what about your father or why is there not a male then? So what Nabiullah Musa did was, he did it for them. He did it for them. And when he did it for them, they went home very early that day. And when they went home that day, their father recognized and he realized that they came home early. And so he questioned them. He said, what is it that brought you guys home early today? What is it that's happened? And so they told him that there was a man who helped them. Many people think that the father of these two daughters was Nabiullah Shu'aib, because Shu'aib was sent to the people of Madian. And so they think, because the place was Madian, so they automatically attribute it to Nabiullah Shu'aib. But no, it's not Shu'aib, it's a man who was righteous, a very righteous man. So what happened was, he went, he ordered one of his daughters to go and get him. So she came walking to him. And the ayah mentions tamshi al istihya, she was walking with shyness. And she went to him and she said to him, Inna abi yad'uka, my father is calling you, liyajziyaka ajra ma saqayta lana. He wants to reward you for that which you have done for us. The Baytul Qasid, the benefit that I want to take from this story is, one of the girls, she said to her father, قالت إحداهما. Allah says that one of the girls, she said, يَا أَبَتِ اسْتَأْجِرُ. When Nabiullah Musa came in, she said to her father, Shu'aib, sorry, she said to her father, this righteous man, who people think is Shu'aib, she said to him, يَا أَبَتِ اسْتَأْجِرُ. Oh father, give this man a job. In other words, istijar means, employ him. Let him work for us. She gave a reason why. This is called ta'leelun li talabiha. She's trying to give a reason why she thinks he should be taken. And she gave two reasons. She said, قالت إحداهما يا أبت استأجره إن خير من استأجرت القوي الأمين. She said, father, the best person who you can employ is one who has two characteristics. And the first one is al-qawi. Strong. A person who is strong. The second one is Al-Amin. A person you can trust. So she said, for those two reasons, I think you should take him, father. This shows us now, and this gives us an impression and understanding. Number one, that this girl was a very smart girl. And she was a very clever girl. Who knew the value of, or knew the quality that a person can be taken for. And the quality that if a person doesn't have, you can reject him for. She basically understood باب المعاملات أما العلاقة بين الناس, the dealings that humans have and the relationships and the transactions that should happen between people. If they don't have quwwah, strength and power, and if there's no amana, that relationship is not going to last for long. Now this can be a relationship between a wife and a husband. It could be a relationship between business partners. It could be the relationship between students who study in college together. It can be the relationship, any relationship that two individuals or more are having, if there's no quwwah and amana on both parties or all parties, then this will lead to destruction or problems within that relationship. The wife, she needs a man who has what? Al-Quwwah wal-Amana. And Nabiullah Musa alayhi salam, he had both. Nabiullah Musa alayhi salam. Walidhalika Allah tabarak wa ta'ala mentions this characteristics in the Quran many times and he attributes it to different types of people. The messenger who conveyed this message to us from Allah tabarak wa ta'ala to Nabiullah Muhammad, Jibreel. Messenger from Allah. Jibreel, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about him, إِنَّهُ لَقَوْلُ رَسُولٍ كَرِيمٍ. This is the speech of a messenger, an honorable messenger, a righteous messenger. This is Jibreel. ذي قوة, one who has strength. عند ذي العرش مكين. مطاع ثم أمين. One who is obeyed and one who is Ameen. So Jibreel's characteristics in Surah Takwir, Ayah 19 to Ayah 21. Allah is describing Jibreel to be one who is what? Quwwah and Amana. Those are the two characteristics. And brothers, these are called Anasirul Najah wal Kamal. It is the distinct, unique characteristics that if a person has, is very successful in life. He's going to achieve a lot. Another place Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala mentions it. In another place Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala, He mentions it. And this is in what? Fi qissati Sulaiman. In the story of Sulaiman. When Nabi Sulaiman was presenting to those who work for him, who is the person who is able to bring for me the arsh of Bilqis, the woman Bilqisa, who can bring me her throne? Before she was Malika Saba, she was the people of Saba's leader. Who can bring me her throne before she comes here? And then one of the jinns, who is an ifrit, he said, so Nabi Sulaiman said, قَالَ يَا أَيُّهَا الْمَلَأُ قَالَ يَا أَيُّهَا الْمَلَأُ. Mala is gathering. All those of you in the gathering, أَيُّكُمْ يَأْتِينِ بِعَرْشِهَا قَبْلَ أَن يَأْتُونِي مُسْلِمِينَ. Who can bring me her throne before she comes to me as a believer? قال عفريت من الجن أنا آتيك به قبل أن يرتد قال عفريت من الجن أنا آتيك به قبل أن تقوم من مقامك وإني عليه لقوي أمين. I will bring it to you before you leave your gathering. And what he meant by this was Nabi Sulaiman, in the morning he would come as a qadi, a judge, and he would leave in the evening. He meant before you finish your shift in the day, I will bring it to you. Why? How can I bring it to you? وَإِنِّي عَلَيْهِ لَقَوِيٌّ أَمِينٌ. Because I have two characteristics. قُوَّةً and أمانة. You can trust me with this. And I have the strength and the ability for it. وَلِذَلِكَ شَيْخُ الْإِسْلَامِ بْنُ تَيْمِيَّةَ رَحِمَهُ اللَّهِ. He mentions, he wrote a whole book on this, by the way, just about these two characteristics. And he called it السِّيَاسَةُ الشَّرْعِيَّةِ فِي إِصْلَاحِ الرَّاعِ وَالْمَرْعِيَّةِ. Where he talks about, how does an Islamic government need to be run? How can a person govern things and control things? A relationship that a person is going through. I said it. If a woman is trying to get married to a brother, she has to look for him in these two characteristics. Has he got quwwa? Is he a strong individual? Strong physically? Strong mentally? Spiritually? Those are the three components that a person has. Physically, he's a strong man. You see, he's not a man who's going to watch his wife get beaten up, or he's going to push her in and say, and run away. No. The second one is, he is spiritually, his iman is high and strong. He's there to make sure that the religion is being implemented in the house, and he's pushing his wife to khair. And mentally, he's not a person who can be belittled in his efforts and his hard work. He comes home and he says, I can't achieve anything. His himma is very low. It's a man who believes that the sky isn't the limit. And the same is with a wife. And also, that quwwah is wrapped with amana. The amana here, Ibn Taymiyyah mentions, is qashyatullah. He fears Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. He also believes, وَأَلَّا يَشْتَرِي بِآيَاتِ اللَّهِ ثَمَنًا قَلِيلًا. He will never sell his religion out for anything. He will never sell his religion short. And is what a government, an Islamic rule, everything is run with. وَلِذَلِكَ, if somebody wants to go detail in more in looking into this, then I advise them to go to that book of Shaykh al-Islam, Ibn Taymiyyah, السِّيَاسَةُ الشَّرْعِيَّةِ فِي إِصْلَاحِ الرَّاعِي وَالرَّعِيَّةِ. I ask Allah تبارك وتعالى, اللهم ارزقنا فهم كتابك والعمل به واجعلنا مما يقوم بحقه وما هو الله. وصلى الله وسلم على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين.